Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei channel. Today in this video, we're going to do this light flare occlusion effect in HitFilm. This effect occurs when you have a light source that is creating a lens flare and a model that passes in front of it. The model will occlude both the light source and the associated lens flare. In this example, I have the Enterprise passing in front of the camera while being backlit by this point light here. I will want to add an interactive visual light with associated lens flare artifacts. If I simply drag a plane layer in and add the light flare effect, I can attach it to the light source. You can see that the interaction with the spaceship and the camera lens is not correct. When the spaceship passes in front of the light source, the lens flare should also be occluded. On the other hand, when the light flare is visible, it should correctly interact with the camera by showing lens flaring artifacts. It is obvious that this light and its associated lens flare are simply sitting behind the spaceship model with no real interaction between the spaceship and the camera lens occurring. So how do you create realistic light interaction between the light source, the spaceship, and the lens of the camera? I will start by duplicating the composite shot and renaming the duplicate lens flare. In the lens flare comp, I will remove all the lighting, any extra render passes of the model, for example this emissive layer, and the background. I will then add a fill color effect to the model and make it black. Now I have a light source that is only visible when it is not being occluded by the spaceship. I can turn off all the extra parts of the light flare, including both the rays and the lens flare artifacts, leaving only the main lens flare visible. Then I will adjust the flare so it is bright enough yet scaled down to the size that I want. Lastly, I will add a gray layer to the top of the stack and put a demult effect on it. This will make the whole composite shot transparent as necessary. When I am ready, I will drag the lens flare composite shot into the main composite shot and make sure that it lines up correctly. Now I can add an auto light flare effect to that layer and tweak the rays and other elements to taste. I can even add multiple auto lens flare effects to create even more dynamic and interesting lens flare artifacting. See how the light and the associated lens flare are now correctly interacting with the spaceship and the camera lens. This brings a realistic look to the lighting of this shot. If you enjoyed this video, please do me a favor and like it. Also, if this is the kind of learning that you're interested in, please consider subscribing to my channel and don't forget to click the bell icon for notifications. Tutorials come out weekly. If you have any questions about this lesson, please leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.